Hey, what's going on, people? The final volume of 74, the final chapters, or the extra chapters of which we talked about, and we talked about the possibilities, has finally been revealed. And to some of you, this will be the biggest slap in the face that you would have ever have read in manga form, possibly even worse than Yu Yu Hakusho. Or is it? First, I'm going to go off my initial reaction, and the many reactions that people are going to go with is, what the actual fuck, Kubo? You gave us 15 pages with 10 of them being nothing but blank pages of little illustrations that he usually does in the corner of his manga volumes. The screenshots I'm showing you right now is literally what he used a full page for. He used a full page, and in the corner he used a little illustration showing something. And a good two of those pages were completely black with just bleach written at the bottom of it. So with all the theories and all the extra content he could have threw in there, the biggest slaps in the face to say, hey, maybe this could have been a bankai, or hey, we could actually get some more kind of development with this and this character, we could actually get a quick synopsis of what happened to all these many characters, we just didn't. And do we have a right to be outraged? I don't know. Because it is quite simply the fact of the internet and the fans kind of blew this out of proportion, and I'm guilty of it, because you expect that, you know, 15 pages is going to be something that, you know, you can actually enjoy and something you can go, oh wow, that's 15 extra pages of content. It doesn't matter how bad we would have taken it, we wouldn't have expected this. Of course, Kubo's not obliged to do these pages at all. It could have just stayed the way it was. So do we have the right to complain? Not really. If Shonen Jump gave him 15 extra pages to fuck around with, he just did that. And that's what we got in the end. So do you know what? We're going to do what we always do best and actually analyze the shit out of it, because why not, right? Now, of course, when first seeing this, I just couldn't fathom the fact that Kubo had literally done this to us. And I would imagine many people are going to rage. Many people are actually outraged. They're like, you fucking cunt. How dare you, you know, slap the fans in the face after being with this for 15 years. But of course, if you guys have read Bleach, and you guys probably have if you're watching this video, you would know that Kubo has added extra detail through these tiny little illustrations, which, you know, goes to beg the question of, you know, a simple image can tell a thousand words. And of course, we all know about Kubo's infamous poems, and some of them are quite symbolic and beautiful in such a way throughout the series and the story. But as of recently, these poems have gone to seem to be something completely real rather than fictional. And to start off with these pages in particular, we get introduced to the last title card of the chapter or the volume. Simply stated, Bleach, 74, the Death and the Strawberry, with little kanji at the top, translating, even if we are without form, we do not start moving forward. Which you can interpret this from many different ways, and as we got more context through the rest of the pages, something's starting to, you know, make me think a little bit. At first, I initially took this as, though, even though these chapters weren't created, or even though, you know, the characters weren't explained, even those without form, being the chapters themselves, they do not stop moving forward, meaning that even though these characters weren't branched out and they weren't able to show what they could do, they still kept moving forward, was my original explanation for this page. But as I'm looking through these blank pages with these small illustrations, seeing this singular piece of sand falling down, being suddenly split in two, falling along with many other pieces of sand, which is Yuwachi's versions of possibilities or universes or fate, as it were, or paths to future. Out of all these singular grains of sand, one has been split open, and as it hits the scales start to break, suddenly falling on the floor, spelling out the word despair, then giving us a completely black page with the words written bleach on it, as this sand has then been stepped on by Ichigo's foot, with again another black page following another page of the stories of Brave. Then following another card showing his thanks to the crew that he's worked with, which he has a surprisingly a big amount of crew for Bleach, since as he did most of the character designs anyway, so I don't know why he's got such a big crew, but either way, that is essentially the extra pages that we got. We got to see some sand fall on the ground, we understand the metaphors of the sand particles, we understand the metaphors of it being split, it's fell on the ground with Ichigo stepping on it saying brave. And again, as I mentioned before, going with that line saying even those without form do not stop moving forward. Well, I'll be completely honest with you, I just don't actually understand the fucking word. Now, I am going to be honest with you and say I actually could be stretching the fuck out of this, and I really generally don't know. As much as I look at this, I can't put my finger onto it. I want to say that after all this despair that we've gone through, the twists of fate that have fallen down to the ground, with Ichigo's foot stepping on this word of despair, something that the fans have gone through, something of which this kind of poem was written towards the fans, that even even those without form can keep on moving forward and it keeps moving forward, then us as the fans, or maybe Bleach itself, can still move forward, and maybe he is trying to do something. I don't know. I'm trying to find a meaning behind all of this. And the footprint saying brave, I don't know. I personally would have liked the word hope, because that would have given us some direction that, hey, even though we haven't got form, there's, you know, still hope for something. But we got brave, and maybe that's because the fans braved it out this far along just to still have hope in this series. I'm not quite sure, but maybe this is something directed towards a real life situation with Kubo or a real life situation with the series, is that maybe if we brave it out, maybe there'll be something else. Those without form can keep moving forward. So can the series keep moving forward? Can we as the fans keep moving forward after all this bullshit? Is there still something more? But I don't know. And that's what I'm doing the video for, is that you guys get to see the chapter. And maybe you guys can think, hey, is this a waste of 15 pages? Or is there something more? Is there something more symbolic or more something poetic? I know it's not something you guys want. It really isn't. It's quite disappointing, I know, but if you look more into it, maybe you can see it in a different light. But I wouldn't blame you if you got disappointed. I wouldn't blame you if you were upset by these 15 pages until we obviously find out more, or someone can explain something a bit more in depth and kind of understand what Kubo is trying to go on here with. But you got to also take into consideration that he wasn't obliged to do these chapters, you know, or this chapter. So he's not obliged to really do anything with these extra pages. He could have left them white for all he knows, or we know, and it really just doesn't matter. At the end of the day, we got them, and they're free, and they're there. So, again, I know it's not the most positive video, but tell me your guys' thoughts in the comment section down below. What do you think these pages mean, or what do you think they symbolize? Do you think there's more meaning behind it, or do you think Kubo is just simply saying, it's done, that's the story, and that's all you're getting? But I'd like to believe that with more news coming, especially with the whole TV Tokyo thing, with Kubo coming back on Twitter, which I will do a separate video on, and this final volume, or this final page is being released, I still like to think there's something more going on, and hopefully the Bleach fandom will have more to look forward to. So, with that being said, I am going to catch you motherfuckers later. You guys, of course, have this fine day. Being handsome as always, people. Peace out.